Second problem, if cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0 equals to sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma, then show that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to sin square alpha, this is equal to 3/2, again equals to sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma. This is also very, very important problem in this exercise. It may appear in the examination. So, now how to solve this problem? So, in this case also, let us say A is equal to cos alpha plus I sin alpha. B is equal to cos beta plus I sin beta. C is equal to cos gamma plus I sin gamma. This we have to assume. So, first add these three. A plus B plus C equals to cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma. All the real parts have been added. Let us add the real parts. We get I times sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma. See, from given data, this becomes 0, this becomes 0. So, 0 plus I into 0, so 0. So, as for the problem, we have to do. In the previous one, actually, that is a cube plus b cube plus c cube, we applied, but we require here a square, b square, c square. So, better square on both sides. Take a plus b plus c is equal to 0, squaring on both sides, If you square on both sides, we get like this. A plus b plus c whole square is equal to 0. Simple algebraic formula. A plus b plus c whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca equal to 0 square is 0. Means here you keep a square plus b square plus c square as it is, a square plus b square plus c square. From these three, you take 2abc common. If you take 2abc common, we get here 1/c. So, plus here we get, that means we can write no problem, 1/a plus 1/b plus 1/c equal to 0. Now, say this is 1 for our convenience. Now, consider separately 1/a plus 1/b plus 1/c. In the previous problem, we have done this one also. In order to find out cos of alpha plus beta plus cos of beta plus gamma plus cos of gamma plus alpha. So, 1/a means 1/, this is cos alpha plus I sin alpha, that becomes cos alpha minus I sin alpha plus cos beta minus I sin beta plus cos gamma minus I sin gamma. Okay? All the real parts are added, cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma Similarly, from this we can write sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma of I. This is 0, this is 0. So, we can write 0. This value is 0. Now, equation 1 becomes, from equation 1, from equation 1, see, this is replaced by 0, 0 into something 0. So, we get a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 0. This relation has been actually established. Now, replace a value, b value, c value there. Let us see what we get. This is cos alpha plus I sin alpha whole square plus cos beta plus I sin beta whole square plus cos gamma plus I sin gamma whole square equal to 0. Now, can we apply De Moivre's theorem in each term? Yes, why not? Let us apply the De Moivre's theorem. If you apply the De Moivre's theorem, we get this is cos 2 alpha plus cos 2 I sin 2 alpha plus now cos 2 beta plus I sin 2 beta plus cos 2 gamma plus I sin 2 gamma equals to 0. In this case also add the all the real parts. Cos 2 alpha plus cos 2 beta plus cos 2 gamma plus I times sin 2 alpha plus sin 2 beta plus sin 2 gamma is equal to 0 plus I into 0, write down, no problem. Here, in order to prove these two cases, you had better to consider only real part. Comparing real parts. Comparing real parts on both sides. On both sides. If you compare the real parts on both sides, very interesting, you will get it. Cos 2 alpha plus cos 2 beta plus cos 2 gamma is equal to, we get 0. Once again, we have to rewind or recall multiple and submultiple angles. This cos 2 alpha, we can write 2 cos square alpha minus 1. This is 2 cos square beta minus 1. This is 2 cos square gamma minus 1, we can write it because we have the formula. What is the formula? Cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. Am I correct? So, this we can write 2 cos square alpha minus 1 plus 2 cos square beta minus 1 plus 2 cos square gamma minus 1 is equal to 0. So, this is 2 cos square alpha, 2 common cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma minus 3 equal to 0. 2 times cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 3. So, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 3 by 2. This is equation 1. Sorry, equation 2. Now, again, this cos square alpha we can from 2, from equation 2. this cos square alpha we can write 1 minus cos sin square alpha plus 1 minus sin square beta plus 1 minus sin square gamma is equal to 3 by 2. Now this becomes 3 minus of sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma is equal to 3 by 2. Now bring 3 by 2 this side, minus of bracket that side. You get sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma is equal to 3 minus 3 by 2. This will be 3 by 2. Say equation 3. Now observe from 2 and 3. From 2 and 3, from 2 and 3 we get, just observe, both values are same, that's why cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 3 by 2 equal to sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma, here also cos square gamma. Hence it is proved.